Hi, I solved this using my computer. The equation is called the Schrödinger Equation in 2D, and I solved it for a double-slit experiment. Let me show you the simulation results first and then explain every detail. Did you see something interesting? I'll explain every detail from the beginning. The yellow, orange, and purple colored bunch at the left side is an electron wave packet. The brighter the color is, the more chance to observe the electron at the position. It starts at here and moves from the left to the right. Two slits are placed here. The slits are nothing but a high wall of potential energy with two small gaps. I set the electron moving too slow so that the electron cannot pass through the wall but small gaps. How about quantum tunneling? The electron cannot tunnel through the wall effectively. In this case, the wall is too high and thick, and the tunneling probability is very low, essentially zero. You can see that some portion of the electron wave packet passed through the gaps. At the same time, you can also see the interference here and there. This is a temporary standing wave due to the interference of the incident wave and a reflected wave. And this is a temporary standing wave in vertical direction due to the reflection at these lines. Here you can see that the electron starts to spread out vertically as it propagates to the right. The electron wave packet appears right behind the wall, and this is diffraction. The electron wave function reflected at these lines make a chessboard-like interference pattern. These patterns can be removed if I make the wall thinner or make the resolution worse, not to observe every detail. Let's move on. The electron spreads out vertically and interferes at the same time. Look at the reflected part. The reflected part shows interference patterns too. And look at this. Due to the vertical reflections at these edges of the wall, gaps work as resonators, trapping electron wave vertically. I placed a detector at here and sum up all the electron wave passing through this line to detect the electron wave. I'll show you what I got at the detector. I got this line of graph. The higher the graph is at the position, the more probability to detect the electron at the position. You might wonder what would happen if I place a single slit only. I'll block here first. Then there. The interference pattern is never observed with a single slit. We observe the interference pattern only when we have two slits, or more precisely, two electron wave packets with different momentum meet in the space. Let me remind you that this is all about only a single electron. The interference pattern can be observed in experiments even when we count the electron one by one. The interference is nothing but a superposition of waves. Alright. Thanks for watching, and please leave a comment if you have any question, and I'll try to answer for you.